Hello again, this is Kent. I hope you are having a good day. I am going to create a flourish. This is what we'll be coming up with. And to do that, we'll have to go through these steps. Making a branch, make stems, leaves, flowers, and then position all everything together. The first thing you want to do is get your pencil tool, your freehand lines. Go up here in the mode and click on spiral path. Maybe give that smoothing a 43, and then go over here to shape and go down to triangle and set that as triangle in. And then what you want to do is you take your left button on your mouse and you just try to do some swirly thing like that. And if you don't like that, delete it and start over, because it doesn't take much. Yeah, that's not good either. Okay, now that is decent. Now, this is a branch, so to do that, or we probably should make this a little thicker. So go up to Path and down to Path Effect Editor, Shift-Control-7 if you want to use your keyboard. Then you go on over here and give that a 5 maybe, or a 4. Let's do a 4. Okay. You don't have to stay in there, but you could if you really want. Okay, so we have our branch. Now we want to create some stems. Now this branch doesn't have to be this big. You could actually start with something smaller, but once you get your final product, you can always make it smaller or bigger, right? So let's make some stems. We'll use the same pencil tool with all the same functions, and then start doing some kind of swirls like this, like that. You don't have to make the noise to make your swirls. Just keep on making a bunch of them. We'll position them later. Now, I didn't like that one. Maybe you could just make one that doesn't. Sometimes it's not always. Doesn't give you what you want. Don't like that. It needs to be curved. Okay. Okay, that's enough. Okay, now let's go ahead and make some leaves. To do that, you'll want to change tools. Use your Bezier tool in your regular mode, Bezier path mode, and then you want to select ellipse. Okay, and then you can go down to a smaller zoom level. Come over here where there's some space. And okay, now we want to make some leaves. So use your Bezier tool, click on that. Go up here in the mode, you want to use your spiral path, and then in the shape you use the ellipse. Then you want to click somewhere in a free white space, and then click there, and then hold your control key down, and then click again with your mouse, your left button on your mouse, then hit enter key on your keyboard. Now this is basically sort of an ellipse. And what we want to do at this point is, and I just hit the space bar to go to my select tool, you want to duplicate it. And then both of these, you want to change them to a path, object to path. So we have two of these. Now, we want to make this into a leaf. Let's just make a simple leaf. So we'll drag this, holding the control key down, drag this part up, and drag this part down. Try to make it somewhat symmetrical. Now, select both nodes, and then with your control key down, you can select this and then hit your control key, and then drag it this way. Okay, now we have the starting of our leaf. Okay, this is will be our it's kind of a stem. So you would just want to flatten it a little. You don't want it too flat. Let's see how it will look. That's not flat enough. Okay, maybe that's flat enough. Okay, try to get that in the middle somewhat, like that. You can push it back a little, I guess. Then you want to select both of these. Have that selected, you want to select this. And then you go up to Path, and then Difference. Okay, so there's our leaf. And we can make a bunch of leaves with this. And you do that. First of all, let's make these a little more proportional. Is that too big? Let's make this a little smaller. There's a way you can make a bunch of leaves at the same time. You can either use your pencil tool, and then you go up here and change this to from clipboard, and then make leaves like this. Oops. First, I'll need to copy that. Go back to the pencil, clipboard from clipboard, and then make some leaves. Yeah, like that. Now, we can always go back and make these small. Okay, so anyway, we have some leaves. And I'd like to make... here's another way to make leaves, but they're not different kind of... we don't get rounded leaves this way. But you can grab this spray tool and click over this. Well, you don't have to click over that, but you can click anywhere here, and it'll just give you a bunch of leaves. Okay, next we will make a flower. Okay, next we'll make the flower, and we'll use this tool, star tool. Make the starting. We can put some fill in there for right now. And we can zoom in on here and then zoom out, and it looks like it has a stroke, and we don't want a stroke. So get rid of that. Let's make this, let's turn it a little so that, like that. Okay. Okay, and then we want to do something similar to the leaves. In fact, we probably could just use one. Bring that up here and paste it. And need to curve this, or not curve it, but rotate it. And then one thing we need to do with these leaves, I forgot to tell you this. Again, we need to select all of them and make them into a path, object to path. Okay, so they're all paths now. That way, when you move them, or even try to, now when you move these, they don't change. You can also curve them, and you can also scale them. Okay, so the same with this one. I'll make this a little thicker. Maybe even a little thicker this way. Okay. Need to slightly make this horizontal. Then you want to go, maybe let's do something here. Yeah, that's not what I really wanted. About... it's a little better, not exactly what I wanted, but anyway, it'll work. So it doesn't really matter what you come up with. We want to make this into, oops, we don't want to do that. We want an object to path. And then we want to subtract this from this item. So we go to the difference. And so we basically have, this is open right here now, just like here. Okay, the next thing we want to do is we want to move the focal point of the rotation. So I'll put it right here in the middle. And then you want to do a control D on this 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then move this out of the way. Okay, so we have 5 copies on top of the original. We want to rotate them in place. You get your control key on your keyboard. And this will move them 15 degrees around, and then it'll stop. As long as you have 6 prongs on here, or something, they have to be, they would like it to be a multiple of 15 degrees over, well, how many 15 degrees are in? There's, anyway, if you have 6 prongs on this middle item, it will work out. I don't want to do it in my head because it'll just, oh, apparently I need, oh, no, I can use this one. There's another one in here. Okay, so we have somewhat of a flower, and you can group that so it doesn't move. You can also shrink it like this, or something like that. You can make some more of those for your drawing. Okay, and now we will position these. And keep in mind that when you position, I'll speed up the video when I do this, but when you position, you can hit your H for horizontal flipping, or vertical key for your to flip things vertically. Also, before I start, you might want to also know that with these stems, you might want to have these thicker at this end and then thinner as they go out this way. And you do that with your path editor, it's down here, the path effect editor. Okay, I will speed it up now. Okay, I'm more or less done, except for you just do what looks good, and this doesn't look, you know, the best, but it's a start, and of course I'm not sure I'd have that big old leaf now that I think about it, but you can always make changes to it. You can actually make a union out of these, the branch and the stems if you want, But that means you can't really change it as easily. I might put some leaves here and so on, but you get the idea. You just make it look, you know, somewhat interesting. And there you have it. I hope you enjoyed it. This is Kent from simpletutorials.net. Thank you very much.